morning, Patriots. I'm Hilda.
Wait, Hilda, aren't we usually on the other side?
It's been a long break.
Much better.
Good morning, Patriots. I'm Hilda.
And I'm Jessica, and welcome back to a new year of BTV.
Happy New Year, Patriots. We hope this year is everything you wish and hope for.
Let's check out this unique piece about starting 2018 right.
What is a goal? How does one achieve a goal? A goal can be the object of a person's ambition or effort, an aim or desired result, the result or achievement toward which effort is directed. It's an ambition, an intention, or a goal can be one's own destination. Martin Luther King Jr. made it his ambition to end the segregation of African Americans during the 1950s. Marie Curie became the first woman to later discover and study the effects of radioactivity, despite the troubles and the struggles faced during her life. Goals are more of a destination. A destination or a place a person wants to achieve within a certain amount of time. Everyone has a finite amount of time. How much are you willing to give in order to achieve your dreams or aspirations? But if you stop for a second, or a simple minute to think, where will you be in the next month, or year, or the next 20 years? What will you be doing during that time? What kind of goals will you be making and achieving?
Super cool. And now here are our first announcements of 2018.
Every Monday, there'll be a Santiago Canyon College rep in the Career Center from 9 to 11 a.m. to assist students on how to apply to community college and answer any questions you may have.
Also coming up is the Teacher Talent Show on Wednesday the 24th at 6:30 p.m.
If you want to see your favorite teachers perform, tickets will be sold for $8 at the door, so don't miss it.
Now, Eden seems to be a little late coming back from her long weekend in Hawaii, so let's go over to Elise with sports.
I gotta say, a fantastic job to our cheer team as they won their division at the Tustin High School competition this past weekend. Boys basketball reigned victorious against Woodbridge on Tuesday with a score of 73-67. Congrats, guys. This past Wednesday, girls water polo triumphed over Northwood with a score of 8-1. You thought? Congratulations to Melissa Moreno for winning her weight class at the San Dimas tournament. Lastly, boys wrestling crushed Northwood with a score of 64-15 at their dual meet on Wednesday. I'm done. Thank God there aren't any balls in wrestling.
Great job, Patriots. Can't wait to see what happens this winter season.
Hey, Hilda, what are your New Year's resolutions?
To get through senior year.
Me too. Maybe some Beckman alumni can help us out.
In high school, I wish that I would have given 100% of myself to my academic, personal, and extracurricular involvements, and I wish that I would have been really rigorous in my assessment of what giving 100% of myself would look like. I wish that I would have spent more time getting to know my teachers outside of class, just talking about life and about their lives, and I wish that I would have put into place and followed through with having a really rigid daily routine and schedule. So I would never run out of time for all the things that I needed to do within a week.
What I wish I knew in high school was that in college you're gonna have to actually apply concepts rather than just memorize them. So it's a good tip to just like start learning how to apply concepts now rather than just getting like hit in the face when you go to college. And another thing is that things will get better even if you're like really like not having a good time in high school. I know like college is like the best thing that's ever happened to me. You're just like leaving high school. So things will get better even if you don't think they will.
One thing I definitely wish I knew in high school was that it's not worth stressing and wasting so much time thinking about where you're gonna go to school, because honestly, wherever you end up is where you end up, and you're gonna thrive in your respective situation. So just have more fun, enjoy different memories, and don't stress about the college process too much, because it all works out in the long run.
I wish I knew that it was okay to be more vulnerable with people.
First thing I'd like to say is give it your all. High school's short and 4 years will go by fast, and you want to look back on the experience with no regrets. And number two is take advantage of every opportunity that comes your way. You don't know how long the opportunity is going to be there, and you want to jump on it as soon as you can.
One thing I wish I knew in high school is that you literally have an entire life ahead of you. So whatever setbacks or negativity you have in your life right now, whether it's a bad grade, a fight with your friends, no one likes you, it's totally okay, because the day you graduate, it's up to you whether or not you want to carry that negativity on with you, or if you just want to start over and enjoy the rest of your life after high school.
I wish I had gotten to know my teachers better. They are a great source of wisdom, and I could always use some. To go to all the games.
Take more pictures with your friends. Make many memories.
Go to the dances. Mm-hmm. Try hard in your classes or harder. Like a few more hours of studying is going to be worth it when you don't fail your A-push test. Be more involved.
Your time isn't going to come back after you graduate, so make the most out of your high school experience.
So one thing I wish I knew in high school was that grades aren't that important. I mean, they are important, but don't let a number define who you are.
My advice for you all is to just be yourself, okay? It's exhausting to try to be somebody else. Trust me, I've been there. And if at the end of the day, nothing goes right, at least you were honest with yourself and you tried your best, and that's really all you can ask of yourself.
It's good to hear we can survive senior year.
All right, Patriots, your next mission is to buy winter formal tickets.
Today, they'll be 50 with ASB and 55 without.
From January 22nd to 26th, tickets will be 55 with ASB and 60 without.
If you want a chance to win two free tickets, tag your asking on Instagram with the hashtag BHSCasinoFormel.
Last but not least, seniors, if you're interested in showcasing your art, send your work to this email by February 17th to be considered.
That's all we have this week, Patriots. Have a good weekend, and we'll see you next time.
I'm Hilda.
And I'm Jess.
Signing off.